This video is sponsored by Carnivore Companion. Hey there, my meaty friends. This is Reed, aka CarnivorousChef, aka Boudin Boy. If you've seen my chicken cordon bleu meatball video, you might know that I ran a little contest on my Instagram. You should definitely go follow my Instagram because I plan on doing more of these. But people ran wild with it, and a few of the answers I got me thinking. Boudin balls is one of the first ones that struck me and made me wonder why I haven't even thought to make it. Maybe it's the rice, and the fact that I'm allergic to rice, that led me to completely disregard it. However, I felt the strongest urge to make them after reading that comment, so here's me doing that. To start, walk in with a soft wiggle, and then grab yourself some pork shoulder of some sort. I get these country style ribs because it's just pork shoulder cut up into strips. A lot of the times it won't even say pork shoulder, but it'll just say country style ribs. This is a great option if you don't feel like getting an entire pork shoulder. Anyways, let's get these fake ribs out and give them a very generous seasoning. This is almost 3 pounds of pork, and I used about a tablespoon of salt for all of it. Get every square inch coated because it definitely needs it. Throw this into an oven at 450 degrees Fahrenheit or 230 degrees Celsius. We want to let it get some good color there, so let it go for about 30 minutes in a convection oven or 40 minutes in a conventional oven. In the meantime, let's get our main flavors together. I'll be avoiding fresh veggies for the obvious reasons and instead opt for dried spices, but feel free to do whatever you want here. In a bowl, you'll want to add in a quarter cup of smoked paprika, 1 tablespoon of celery salt, 1.5 tablespoons of granulated garlic, 1 tablespoon of granulated onion, 1 teaspoon of ground cayenne pepper, and finally a quarter teaspoon of black pepper. Give that a hot whisking and then stick your face in it and breathe deep.
Oh yeah, that's good.
Set that aside while we deal with our now well-roasted pork. Add in 4 cups of water or stock of your choice, as well as 3 tablespoons of your newly made spice mixture. We want this braised semi-low and semi-slow, so cover it very tightly with aluminum foil and place it back into your oven. However, this time set your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 175 degrees Celsius. Let it cook for 1 hour and 15 minutes in a convection oven or 1.5 hours in a conventional oven. While that's in the oven again, we could take care of our livers. Place a pan over medium-high heat along with 2 tablespoons of ghee or butter. I added in 1/2 pound of chicken livers and gave them a hard sear. Once I finally flipped them, I decided to add in about 1 tablespoon of the Cajun spice we made earlier. Flip these occasionally and cook until they're about medium. Once there, set them aside and it's finally time to pull out our pork. It should be nicely falling apart tender. Remove the pork from the pan, reserving the braising liquid. We're about to be grinding this, so we want to give this a rough chop. Also, if you have a grinder, use the largest grinding plate you have. I did a review on this grinder, but nobody seemed to care, and if you want to see that review, I'll post the link to the video down in the description. Grind or chop up all of your little porky cubes, followed by your chicken livers. What you're looking for is a loose yet fine texture on the pork, and the liver should be creamy. Now we've got that all ground up, let's fortify it. Add in 2 teaspoons of the only hot sauce I had on hand, along with 2 teaspoons of salt, 2 teaspoons of our spice mix, about 2 tablespoons of pork rinds, and 1 egg as a binder, and finally about 1/3 cup of our braising liquid. Thoroughly mix this by hand before throwing it into our fridge for about 1 hour to chill out. Once out, we can finally bread these puppies, little Boudin puppies. Grab a sheet tray and spread out some of the pork rinds. Make a meatball by any means necessary. I'm using a cookie dough scoop to make mine much less of a hassle. Roll it around on the pork rinds and then press it in. Complete the round shape based on your OCD needs. Finish up with the rest of your ingredients until you're done. And once you're done making these, about 24 to 30 of them, place them back into your oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 175 degrees Celsius for 15 to 20 minutes or until crispy on the outside. Let's get these quickly plated up because I'm excited to take this first bite, which is for my Patreon community. You should join us if you want to be a part of the Cool Kids Club. I'm super happy about putting these balls in my mouth. Holy shit, these are good. I'd like a sauce like a remoulade to go with these, but I'm feeling a bit lazier than normal, so I'll just have to suffer without it. I'd like to make you a bit more saucy, but you'd have to like the video and subscribe to the channel to make that happen.
Check out our newly released seasoning steak dust, along with our flagship seasoning smokestack and our bestseller Tuckologen. Use the code CCYouTube10 at carnivorecompanion.com to save 10% off your first order.
I'm super happy about putting these balls in my mouth.